श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम्। सो यस्टर्डे वी सॉ दि त्री गुण सत्व रजस एंड तमस दि डिफरेंसेस इन त्री गुण। वी सॉ दि स्वरूप ऑफ त्री गुण दि लक्षण ऑफ त्री गुण दि भाव ऑफ ऑल दि त्री गुणास एक्सेट्रा एंड दि डिफरेंट स्टेट्स ऑफ बुद्धि एंड अहंकार इन दीज त्री गुणास हाउ दे रियाक्ट हाउ दे बिहेव दट ऑल्सो वी सॉ। सो प्रधान विल कम टू दिस प्रधान अगेन। प्रधान मीन्स दि साम्यवस्था दि स्टेट ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम एंड वी हैव सत्व रजस एंड तमस थ्री गुणास। सो फ्रॉम दि सत्व गुण वी हैव बुद्धि। दिस इज सृष्टि प्रक्रिया। We have buddhi. Buddhi is one. We have, because of rajoguna prakriti, we have ahankara. Ahankara also one. From buddhi, ahankara comes into existence. Buddhi is also called as mahat. Okay? From buddhi, ahankara comes into existence. From ahankara, tanmatra. Tanmatras are five. Pancha tanmatras. Okay, so pancha tanmatras, you have the seven, which is a prakriti vikriti, both cause and effect. Buddhi is effect of pradhana, cause for ahankara. Ahankara is effect of buddhi, cause for tanmatra. Tanmatra is cause of ahankara and effect of the pancha bhuta. Effect of ahankara and cause of pancha bhuta. Now, this Vikriti, Prakriti Vikriti Visa, now we have to see the Vikriti Srishti. Vikriti Visa to be 16. They are Jnanindriya, Karmendriya, Manah, and Panchabhuta. Panchatanmatra from the Panchabhuta. Tanmatra from the Panchabhuta. Jnanindriya is 5. Karmendriya also 5. Manas 1. Panchatanmatra 5. So we have 16. Now here, the Jnanindriya, Sattva-guna is predominant. Rajoguna is a secondary. In Karmendriya, Rajoguna is predominant and Sattva-guna is secondary. For Manas, Rajoguna and Sattva-guna are equal, not too different. See, it depends upon the activity. Jnanindriya, sense organ of jnana, knowledge. Karmendriya, sense organ of action. Mind is sense organ of both action and knowledge. Tanmatras are the basic elements from which the five elements come into existence. Now, we will see the Jnanindriya, Karmendriya and their Vishaya. Jnanindriya and Karmendriya. It's called Jnanindriya because it illumines the knowledge of the object. It is called Karmendriya because it involves itself in the action. Jnanindriya, Indriya and Vishaya. Karmendriya, Indriya and Vishaya. You'll see like this. Jnanindriya. We have Chakshu, Shrotra, so Dhrana, Dhrana, Rasana, Tvak. For this, Rupa is this Vishaya, Rupa, Shrotra, Shabda, Dhrana, Ganda, Rasana, Rasa, Tvak, Sparsha. See, chakshu, eye. For eye, form is the object. For ears, sound is the object. For ghrana, ghrana means nose. For the nose, smell, gandha is the object. For rasana, the taste bud, rasa, taste is the object. For tvak, the sense organ of touch, sparsha, touch is the object. Now, this is the karmendriya, jnanendriya. Now, we have karmendriya.
Vak, pani, pada, payu, upastha.
Vak, pani, pada, payu, upastha. Vak, vachana.
Vachana, adana, viharana, payu, malatyaga, and ananda.
Vak, the sense organ of speech. For that, speech is the vishaya. Send the hand, hands. So for hands, give and take is the vishaya. Pada, for the legs, viharana, movement is the vishaya. For the payu, for the sense organ of excretion, malatyaga, excreting is the vishaya. For upastha, sense organ of procreation, ananda, enjoyment is the vishaya. So, these are the vishaya, indriya and vishaya for jnana and karma. Jnanendriyas and karmendriyas and their vishayas. The jnanendriya and karmendriya only objectify things which is in the present tense, in the present, present time, present period. Now, sunk mind, we have to, next,
budhyante iti
jnanendriya, karma kurvanti iti karmendriya, like that you have to understand.
Karma kurvanti karmendriya, budhyante iti jnanendriya.
Now, mind is ubhayatmaka, both karmendriya and jnanendriya. The nature of mind is sankalpa vikalpatmaka manaha.
Manaha is both karma and jnana.
Both karma and jnana indriya. The definition for mind is sankalpa. Lakshana for mind is sankalpatmaka. Manaha sankalpatmaka. Sankalpa vikalpatmaka basically. Sankalpatmaka means it is like this. It is not like this. In this way, that which behaves undesiredly, it is mind. If it is decided, this is what it is, then it is buddhi. Okay? We have already seen that. So, karmendriya. And
mind, no, buddhi, manaha,
ahankara and mana. Ahankara and mana.
Buddhi, ahankara, mana.
For this, buddhi, ahankara and mana, it is objectifying. See, the karmendriyas and jnanendriyas, they objectify only things of the present. Buddhi, ahankara and mind, they objectify things of all the three periods of time, past, present and future.
Mind, with association with the sense organ, brings the object. With or without association, brings the sense, the knowledge to the mind, ahankara.
Ahankara associates itself with it. I know this, I don't know this, in this way.
And then it presents it to
the buddhi. Buddhi illumines it. And that is because of the association of the Chaitanya Purusha, the sentient being which is Purusha, it behaves as though it is also sentient. Okay, so the general, each of them have a specific action. Buddhi, Nishyatmaka, it decides this is what it is. Ahankara, Abhimana, it identifies itself with the knowledge. Mind behaves undecidedly. But though they have their special action, there is a common action for all this. Five pranas.
Prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana.
ఆపాన వ్యాన ఉదాన సమాన దీస్ ఆర్ ది ఫైవ్ వైటల్ యాస్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఇస్ ది కామన్ ఫర్ ఆల్ దిస్ బుద్ధి అహంకార అండ్ మైండ్ ఇట్స్ అ కామన్ వృత్తి కామన్ యాక్టివిటీ ఫర్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్ నౌ వి హావ్ టూ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ నాలెడ్జెస్ వన్ ఇస్ ప్రత్యక్ష అండ్ అదర్ ఇస్ పరోక్ష ఇన్ బోత్ ప్రత్యక్ష అండ్ పరోక్ష వి హావ్ టూ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ possibility of knowledge. One is Yugapath, the other is Krama.
Pratyaksha. Pratyaksha means
you perceive immediately, direct perception. Now.
Now, that is
only for the present period.
There are two ways to gain that. Yugapath and Krama.
Yugapath means at the same time the knowledge will be gained. Krama means in a series of orders. Like for the pratyaksha, the indriya
plus mind plus ahankara plus buddhi.
These four, when they group together, you have pratyaksha jnana. Indriya brings the object to mind, mind brings it to ahankara, ahankara identifies itself and presents it to the buddhi, and buddhi illumines it. So this is the order of the pratyaksha. When all of them are associated with the object, then it is Yugapath at the same time.
When each one of them, first Indriya, then it presents it to mind, then it presents to Ahankara, then it presents to Buddhi,
there is an order series, then that order is called Krama.
Okay, this is with reference to Pratyaksha, which objectifies only the present tense. Now, there is Paroksha,
which is for all the three periods, past, present and future.
Without the sense organ, you have mind, ahankara and buddhi like we already said. This also takes place in Yugapath and Krama.
Both possibilities are there, Yugapath and Krama. Now, after explaining the
creation, we have to understand the buddhi creation, the srishti of buddhi. This
srishti of buddhi is accepted to be 50 types.
Buddhi srishti is of 50 types.
50
types. First is viparyaya. Second is
viparyaya tushti siddhi.
Tushti. Third is ashakti. Fourth is Siddhi.
Viparya is of five types.
Tushti Ashtada.
28.
No, Tushti is 9. Siddhi is 8 types.
Viparya is 5 types. This is what the Patanjali Yoga Sutrakara says. Avidya, Spita, Raga, Dvesha, Abhiniveshaha, Panchaklesha. Viparya is Panchaklesha.
This is born out of Ajnana.
We have to understand everything with relation to the four bhavas. Dharma, Jnana, Vairagya, Aishwarya. Adharma, Ajnana, Vairagya, Anishwarya.
So, Ajnana, because of ignorance,
you have Viparya. Erroneous knowledge, wrong knowledge.
Now, because of the Dharma, the positive qualities, except the knowledge. Dharma, Vairagya, and Aishwarya.
The positive bhavas, positive qualities. Now, because of that, you don't have the knowledge, you don't have the discriminate power. Therefore, what happens? You go and settle in the prakriti. Residing in the prakriti is called as tushti. Prakriti bhava is called as tushti. They are of 9 types. Now, ashakti means no power to do anything. This is because of, see here, you have all the positive qualities. Here, Adharma, all the negative qualities you have. Avairagya and Aneshwarya. Because of Adharma, Avairagya, Aneshwarya, you have Ashakti. The non-potentiality, impotential, non-potentiality to do anything, to gain the knowledge,
to gain the state of liberation. These three are in the state of bandha, bondage. Siddhi is in the state of moksha. Since it is in the state of moksha, this is because of purely
the jnana. So you have jnana, you have ajnana one place, dharma vairagya aishwarya, adharma vairagya aneshwarya. So you have all the eight bhavas which give different experiences. So except jnana, the other, all of them are in the state of bondage. But the positive qualities definitely help you to gain the knowledge. So this is the 50 types of buddhi, buddhi srishti.
The srishti, again, we saw sharira, shiryate aneniti sharira, that which through which all the experiences are taken taking place is sharira.
The sharira we explained in the beginning. There are two types of experiences of adhyatmika. One is sharirika, the other is manasa.
Sharira is of two types. One is sthula srishti, the other is sukshma srishti.
Sthula srishti cannot exist without sukshma srishti, sukshma sharira.
Sthula sharira depends upon the sukshma sharira for its existence.
Without sukshma sharira, subtle body, sthula sharira means gross body, sthula means gross, sukshma means subtle. Without the subtle body, the gross body cannot exist.
The subtle body also
has different states. The subtle body, when it is explained as nitya, eternal. This nitya should be understood. It is eternal till the creation, till the pralaya takes place, till the dissolution takes place, or till the moksha. It will be sthayi, it will be eternal.
Then, sarvavyapi.
It is omnipresent, all pervading. Then we have,
it is a creation of mind, ahankara, buddhi, and tanmatra.
Mana, ahankara, buddhi, tanmatra, mana, ahankara, indriya, not buddhi, indriya nirmita.
Mana, ahankara, indriya
plus tanmatra.
It is created by the sukshma sharira, the subtle body is created by mind, ego,
indriya, sense organs, and the tanmatras.
Okay. Then, the sukshma sharira is endowed with the dharma and adharma qualities.
Dharma and adharma. Dharma is punya, adharma is papa. It is endowed with punya papa.
Then again, for sukha adi bhoga. Sukhadi bhoga rahitam. It is not
associated with the enjoyments of happiness, bliss, etc.,
sorrow, etc. This is sukshma sharira. Now, purushartha hetu. This is the final. Purushartha hetu.
Subtle body is the cause for gaining the purushartha. Purushena archyate prarthyate iti purushartha, meaning to gain the dharma, jnana, vairagya, moksha, etc. For all that, you have to depend upon subtle body.
Purushartha means the four purushartha, chatupurushartha. We have the dharma, artha, kama and moksha. These four purushartha's.
For gaining all that, you have to depend upon the subtle body. Now, the moksha is gained by gaining the knowledge of
vyakta, avyakta and jnya. They manifest the unmanifest under purusha.
This is what we saw in the beginning. So, we have to gain the knowledge of each one of them.
So, we will understand it like this. Vyakta, avyakta. Vyakta means the manifest. Manifest is the srishti, whatever, mahadadi.
Buddhiyadi. All that is vyakta.
Avyakta, unmanifest is pradhana. Okay, now there are two states. One is virupa, other is a sarupa, samanarupa. Vyakta and avyakta, they are similar in some places. They are dissimilar in some things. So we'll see the dissimilarity. Vyakta is a, because if you see the dissimilarity, you can equate the dissimilarity with the Purusha also. So the dissimilarity is common for Purusha and Pradhana. Okay.
Now, Vyakta is
Hetumatu.
Hetu asya asti iti Hetumatu, meaning that which has a beginning, that which has a cause. All that which is manifest, the creation has a cause. Whereas Pradhana and Purusha have no cause. Vyakta is
Anityam. Vyakta is
non-eternal, limited.
But Purusha and Pradhana are eternal, nitya.
Vyakta is
avyapi.
Not all-pervading, not omnipresent.
But Purusha and Pradhana are both
all-pervading, vyapi.
Vyakta is sakriya.
Has activity.
Purusha and Pradhana are akriya.
They don't have any activity. They don't
act.
They don't perform any action.
Anekam.
Vyakta is aneka, manifold.
Purusha,
Pradhana is not manifold. Pradhana is one.
Purusha,
though they accept, is as manifold. This is one small change there.
Normally, everywhere they say, this is Purusha and Pradhana, this is common. This whatever is contradictory, opposite is common. But not so. This Aneka is not common in
Pradhana, in Purusha. Because Purusha is not Eka, it is also Aneka. That is how we explained.
Now, Vyakta is Ashrita.
Is dependent upon something or other.
But Purusha and Pradhana are not dependent. They are independent, anashrita. Vyakta is linga. Linga means
layayukta, not leenavartham gamayati. Layayukta. Layayukta means that which has a merging. That which dissolves, that which merges in its cause.
Since Pradhana and Purusha don't have any cause, they don't merge. They are alinga.
Vyakta is
savayava. Savayava. Savayava means
with limbs.
Whereas Purusha and Pradhana
have no limbs,
no parts.
Vyakta is
paratantra. Vyakta is Purusha and Pradhana are niravayava. Vyakta is
paratantra. Is always dependent upon other.
But Pradhana and Purusha are swatantra,
independent.
So, this is the difference between the Vyakta, Avyakta, and this is the commonality between the
Avyakta and Purusha, the Pradhana and Purusha.
Now, we will see the Sarupa, Samanarupa. This Vyakta, again same, Avyakta.
Sarupa.
Vyakta is Triguna. Pradhana is also Triguna.
Vyakta is
Aviveki. Triguna means endowed with three qualities, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. Pradhana also is endowed with three qualities, Sattva, Rajas and Tamas. Vyakta is inert.
Avyakta also, Pradhana also is inert.
Vyakta is Triguna. Vishayaha. Objects.
Object of Purusha. Experience and for knowledge.
Avyakta. Pradhana also is object.
Vyakta is
Samanya. Is common for all the Purusha.
Pradhana is also common for all the Purusha.
Vyakta is Achetana. Inert.
Avyakta. Pradhana also is Achetana.
Vyakta is प्रसव धर्मी
means it becomes cause and it creates something.
Pradhana also
becomes cause and creates something.
Pradhana is also prasavadharmi. Now with this whatever you have
opposite is
purusha. See, vyakta and avyakta, this is commonality, but it's contradictory to the purusha, meaning
purusha is not triguna. Purusha is not aviveki, purusha is viveki, purusha is intelligent. Purusha is not a vishaya, object, he is a subject. Purusha is not samanya, it is a vishesha, special. Purusha is not achetana, insentient, sentient, chetana. Purusha is not prasavadharmi, he is not a cause for anything. This you have to add, understand also. In Tamil, I didn't explain this. Now,
the Purusha, the four states of Purusha
are explained in this way.
Purusha is explained, accepted to be Bhokta. So, this Purusha,
he has, who is Bhokta?
He is a Madhyasthya.
Madhyasthya.
Sakshi. Kaivalya. And Drashta.
Madhyasthya, Sakshi, Kaivalya and Drashta. Madhyasthya means he is like a judge. He is not biased. Sakshi means he is just a witness. Kaivalya means he is always realized. Drashta means he is a seer.
This is what is said in the Shruti as
in Vedanta generally for Atma, this is what is explained.
Nitya, Siddha, Buddha, Mukta, Drashta, Akarta.
Siddha, Buddha, Mukta, Subhavaha, Atma, they say, this is how they explain in Vedanta. So this is what is the understanding of Sankhya. If you know the difference between Vyakta, Avyakta and Purusha, if you are able to differentiate these things, that is what is a moksha according to the Sankhyans. Harihi Om.